Hi.
Dominic.
Hi, how you doing?
Welcome to Dallas, where we live large and think big. Thank you for joining us.
Oh, you're more than welcome.
Well, thank you. I think we talked last week about wild things with Dominic Monaghan.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, I had a chance to once again watch your show. It's thrilling. It's something else, and I'm scared of spiders, but it's pretty good.
It's definitely something else. I agree with that. You know, it's a combination of a few things, really. I mean, obviously, it's a nature show, but then I'm also trying to have people think a little differently about travel and about street food and, you know, just kind of taking a few risks in the way that we view the world, really.
Well, talk a little bit about different, because I didn't get to explore just a little bit about you being part of Lost, but really Lord of the Rings.
Yes. Yeah, you know, I'm an actor, you know, so I've been lucky enough to be involved with different projects along the years. And then I found myself in a situation where I thought, well, you know, I obviously have a lot of different interests in different things. And one of the major things is the way that I travel is a little differently than probably most people. You know, I tend to go looking for animals. And I thought, well, there's a show in here somewhere because, you know, the animals are not, you know, dogs and cats and horses and ponies. I tend to go and look for slightly more bizarre animals. And I thought that, you know, potentially people might want to see that. And that's how the show got born.
Is it true that your home, you kind of turned into a menagerie?
A little bit, yeah. I have some snakes and some spiders, lizards, praying mantis, a centipede. I actually don't have that many animals right now for me. I usually have quite a few more. But because I've been traveling so much, I've kind of slimmed down my menagerie. But I also have friends that work at the Natural History Museum, and they have animals, and we kind of, you know, take care of each other's animals, you know, throughout the year.
Okay. Now, what will we see on the show? Will that intersect with, I know it will intersect with your love, but will it intersect with your home? Tell us what you want to show us in the scope of the show.
You don't really see a huge amount. You know, it's not reality TV. Lots of people are saying that to me. Oh, you're doing a reality TV show. I am not doing a reality TV show. I am not Kim Kardashian.
Let's make that clear.
Let's
right
just
now.
Be very clear. My breasts are not as significant as hers are. I'm doing a nature show, you know. I'm doing a travel nature show. So you definitely see the way that I travel. You see the things that I need when I travel. You know, I carry around my music. You know, I always carry around a soccer ball. I go around the world and, excuse me, you just see the food that I eat, the things that I like to do. You know, I like to talk to strangers. People who, I don't understand their language, they don't understand mine. I try and make myself understood. I eat slightly daring food. I do some weird things. Tonight, you're going to see an episode where I look for the world's largest spider. And the show's on BBC America, 10:09 Central. I think that's channel 264 for most people. So I go to Laos in Southeast Asia looking for the world's largest spider, which has only been documented in Western science by the National Geographic team, and that was in the year 2000. So an extremely hard to find species.
Well, like I told you, I'm afraid of spiders and allergic to spiders, so I'll have to watch that one from a
distance. Can work on that, you know. You know what, I tend to tell people who are scared of spiders, certainly in this country and in some other countries, is, you know, the vast majority of them are not dangerous, and also they don't really know you exist. You know, the spider that lives in your bathroom or the spider that lives in your kitchen, they don't know that you're there. They don't know there's a human being that they're sharing space with. They found a nice, warm, dry place, and they're trying to live their life, you know.
That's amazing. I never thought of it that way. Well, look, Dominic, I think you're fascinating, and I know your show is fascinating. But I also, too, I found fascinating, other than you being in the Lords of the Ring, you have one of the longest names I've ever encountered.
Well, you mean like my middle names and stuff?
Is it true? It's Dominic, Bernard, Patrick, Luke, Monaghan?
Yeah.
That's one of the longest names I've encountered in a long time.
Thank you very much. Yeah, well, it's my royal heritage. You know, I'm English, so I am in some way connected to the Queen. No, that's not true. I'm named after both my grandparents, who are now sadly deceased. My mom's dad was called Bernard. My dad's dad was called Patrick. And then when I was 13 years old, I was allowed to pick a name for myself. I was such a Star Wars fan. I wanted to pick Han because I like Han Solo. That got nixed by my parents. So then I chose Chewbacca, and they said, absolutely not. So then I took a little bit of time away, and I chose Luke, and they were okay with Luke. But I did that because of Luke Skywalker, you know.
I adore it. I adore you, and I like your show. Once again, tell us when you want us to watch on BBC.
It's Wild Things with Dominic Monaghan tonight, 10, 9 Central.
I will be watching. Please come back, Dominic, because I know you're going to have fascinating adventures, and I love people who love to have the adventures of life. Thank you so much for being on the Val Dubini Show.
It's nice to talk to you. See you later.